Hi everybody, welcome to TFT Tarot for Today, Divine Dabblings with Oberon and Banshee. This is me, Oberon, with my emotional exchanges, my Friday show, which goes into love, emotions, relationships, things of that sort. Who is coming towards you? What are the challenges or opportunities in your relationship? So I'm kind of shaking it up as usual. So we're going to start off with who's coming towards you. And this is who's coming towards you in love or emotional interest. And I'm not necessarily screening this for just single people. This is for anybody who may be interested in somebody who may be interested. So no questions asked. Don't know if you're dating a lot without commitment, whether you're in an open relationship, you're a swinger. Haven't had those since the 70s or 80s, perhaps. Anyways, here we go. So we're going to do this for the elemental signs of the zodiac. So our first up are Aries. I'm sorry, air signs. Air signs. Our first up are air signs, Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. Who is coming towards you? So we're just turning cards until we come to the first court card. All right, so I think we're going to do this for the Geminis, and this is the King of Cups. It's known as the King of Flutes in this deck, the Final Rose. It says single dad. So this is the kind of person, whether you're male or female, whether you're interested male or female, they may not necessarily be male or female, but they present as somebody who is like the single dad, somebody who cares enough about their children to really take care of them. Somebody who's responsible, somebody who wants to be them, somebody who's benevolent and compassionate, somebody who loves unconditionally. So that's who's coming towards you, Gemini. So now we're going to say, who's coming towards Libra? Well, Libra, there'll be a long time coming, I suppose. Sometimes when we do this, the longer it takes to come to that court card, because we're only looking for a court card, and in this case, it's the King of Rings, also considered the King of Pentacles, the King of Coins, says the Jeweler. So this is somebody who is masterful, kingly, about material things. This is somebody that could potentially own their own business or be in charge of a business. This is somebody who organizes and produces money. Well, they could be an earth sign. Whether you are male or female, they could be male or female. They are coming towards you, Libra. All right, and then filling out the air signs is Aquarius. And you have the King of Cups. You have the single dad. So similar vibe to Gemini, Aquarius. the person who is interested in you, who thinks about you, whether you're available to them or not, whether they're actually available to you or not, is somebody like this. They could be a cup, a water sign. They could be a mature person, somebody who's kind of in charge of their thing, successful in life. They're about being kind, compassionate, helpful, benevolent. They are, in fact, the single dad type, but they're also the kind grandfather, the kind guardian. They take care of people. That's who's coming towards you, Aquarius. All right. All right, now we are moving on to the fire signs. Fire signs are Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. Who's coming towards you? And who's coming towards you, Aries? Somebody with the energy of the Queen of Pentacles. This is the Queen of Pentacles reversed. It says the single mom. As the Queen of Pentacles reversed, they may be coming towards you, but they may be more self-interested most of the time. They may find that they feel they're always needing attention. They always need to be everyone else's priority. So they present maybe as a selfish kind of person. They could be an earth sign. They are not necessarily male or female, as you are not necessarily male or female. But if if you are possibly wondering, this is the kind of person that is coming towards you, Aries. All right. Leo. Who is coming towards Leo? And once again, this is whether or not you are already in a relationship or even interested. This is purely about somebody who may be interested in you. And it's the reversed King of Wands, called the King of Roses here. This is a person who is anti-charismatic, Leo. They may be somebody who literally presents as kind of the opposite like of you, that where you are charming, they are discharming. Where you are polite, they are not necessarily polite. So why this person is coming towards you is a mystery. It may be that they are drawn to the idea of being so opposite you and that it intrigues them. I don't necessarily see anything wrong here, but I don't necessarily see anything to be gained. All right, so now we will move on to the Sagittarians of the fire signs. And it's once again the King of Pentacles, the King of Rings. It's upright. This is somebody who is very good at managing things, especially the material things. They are the kind of person that maybe brings with them a strong sense of community, security, and also the comfort of really being comfortable financially. That's that kind of person for you, Sagittarius. And now we are on the water signs. Water signs are Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces. Who is coming towards you? Who's coming towards you, Cancer? And it's the Page of Wands. it's a young person or somebody who is maybe feeling young to you, feeling possibly less mature, not necessarily, they may actually be somebody who works as a courier of some sort. Maybe they deliver things for a living or somehow in their vocation. Delivering things could be even the sense of somebody who maybe connects wires for a cable company or something to do with computers that are connected too. So it's not necessarily the old-fashioned drive to the post office and pick up the mail kind of person or go to the bank for bank business. But beyond that, they are a person who is inquisitive and possibly bearing good news as well. They may have honorable intentions, but they may feel like they're just a little bit young for you. All right, so now we will move on to Scorpio. Scorpio, it's the Queen of Swords. Ooh, it says the bitch. In this deck, the Final Rose, she's called the Queen of Mirrors. Note those killer high heels. So the Queen of Swords for Scorpio presents as the kind of person who's very determined to have you one way or the other, whether they're male, female, whether you're male or female. They're very charismatic, challenging, brave, maybe even demanding kind of person. They really sort of expect to get what they want in their own way. So I think that's what's coming. And the thing is that they don't necessarily take no for an answer. All right, so now we're going to move on to Pisces. Pisces, who's coming towards you? And it's the King of Wands, King of Roses, and the King of Wands is sort of a reversed, is sort of somebody who maybe, like I said before, they're not necessarily very charming. They may be demanding. They may be somebody that feels attention is owed to them, but they really turn people off. I could also say, too, that they're overly confident and that this may be a person who actually thinks you would want them, and it may be that you will not. So that's it for the water signs. We're going to move on to the earth signs. Earth signs are Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Who's coming towards you, Capricorn? And it's the Queen of Wands reversed. And the Queen of Wands is even more anti-charismatic, perhaps, than the King of Wands. The Queen of Wands is overly ambitious and overly pushy and sort of never notices anybody else. So when they notice you, it's more likely than not because they're looking for somebody who basically will give them extra detail. And they don't necessarily care about you. I'm just going to say it that way. So that was Taurus. Virgo, who is coming towards Virgo? And it's the Knight of Swords. It says the meathead. And the Knight of Swords is somebody who's not very young, but not necessarily very mature. They sort of rush into things. And they're brash, they're arrogant, they're not necessarily bad, but they may have expectations that are unrealistic. So the Knight of Swords could be an air sign. They could be one of the air signs, but they're not necessarily built for the long run. They may peter out after a lot of energy is displayed. Virgo, moving to Virgo to Capricorn. Who's coming towards you? And it's the Queen of Wands again. She's upright, so she's in a better light. The person moving towards you, Capricorn, could be a fire sign. They are very charismatic. They are alluring. They are captivating. They seem to draw people in. They're mostly kind, but they are mostly about themselves first and foremost. They're not a bad person, but they put themselves at the very, very, very top above almost anything else. All right, so that's it for who's coming towards you. I think I'm going to briefly throw one set of cards, the Tarot of Oppositions, and I'm just going to do this real quickly for the signs, the elemental signs of the zodiac, one card for each elemental sign. The basic idea with the Tarot of Oppositions is it sort of gives us the opportunity to look at both the reversed and the upright meanings of the card and feel what is that liminal space there in between, or to actually vacillate between those qualities if possible. So we're going to do this under the idea of what are the challenges or opportunities in your relationship, and that's whether it's the relationship that happens after somebody comes towards you, as we just did, or whether it's a relationship you already have. So just like the other part of the reading, this is for all sides. That's not what I meant. This is for people who are either single or in relationships. And of course, I'm using the Tarot of Oppositions. So here we go. What is the challenge or opportunity for the air signs? And once again, air signs are Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. And it's the Queen of Wands. And the Queen of Wands showed up several times in the readings today. So it's kind of easy. The opportunity is to grow, is to present yourself as interested and captivated and allured by the relationship you have as you always had. The challenge may be that things are different. Things have changed, and that maybe the sense of interest and captivation has waned a little bit. And so that is what the air signs have to work on, is dealing with their attraction to the relationship and whether they really feel they are at that best quality. You know, people have marriages or relationships for a lot of reasons, but actual physical passion has to be some of them. And if we don't feel that passion, then we have to figure out what we can do to bring that back. All right, what is the challenge or opportunity to a relationship for the fire signs? And fire signs are Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. And it's the Hierophant, both reversed and upright. So for fire signs, this is also very clear. The challenge in the relationship is either to keep it stable and conventional, or to maybe get a little adventurous, get a little wild. But in a way, it's the challenge too, as well as the opportunity. The challenge is to keep it more wild and interesting, or is the challenge to move it further along into a deeper part of the relationship that basically does seem more conventional? Only the fire signs know. All right, water signs. Challenges or opportunities in the relationships, whether it's one you have now or whether it's that one coming to you. What is that? Water signs, Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces, what is the challenge or opportunity in relationships? And reversed or upright, it is the Four of Wands. And of course, this is a card that rarely has really very bad with it. Of course, for the purposes of the Tarot of Oppositions, it does look like a darker sky there. But I'm going to kind of go with the idea that I normally feel from the Four of Wands, whether it's reversed or not. And I'll just say that the challenge or the opportunity is mostly making sure things are happy. And that there is a great opportunity to make it happy. And that even that happiness, if it's just a portion of happiness, it would be satisfying. But there's also a challenge in taking something that maybe is not quite as satisfying and try to make it a much more satisfying love, home life, emotional life, etc. So now finally, on to the earth signs. Earth signs are Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. What are the challenges or opportunities in your relationship, in your set of relationships, in the ones that you think are moving towards you or that you are moving toward? Earth signs, Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. And it's the reversed and upright Knight of Wands. So So as a challenge, the Knight of Wands needs to bring interest, confidence, bravery, a dash of charisma or charm into a relationship, or as they move towards a relationship or within the relationship that's moving to that area. But that's an opportunity. The challenge may be also the same, the other side of that, the idea that something is defeating the purpose, something is not extolling the best virtues of yourself in this relationship, showing your own confidence. Maybe you are challenged by the fact that you don't feel really up to the mettle of that relationship. You may have to do some seriously thinking about that, unless you realize this is just a phase and that maybe at some point you will shift this way. Either way, the challenge and the opportunity is keeping relationships interesting, charming, approaching new boundaries or borders. So that's my emotional exchanges reading for the week. Thanks for coming. And I use the Tarot of Oppositions and the Final Rose Tarot for these readings. Don't forget to watch Happy Hour tomorrow at 10 a.m. and then our live show on Sunday afternoon, 2 to 4. But before that, Banshee is also on in a recorded show at 10 a.m. Banshee's Material Matters. She does for your material matters what I hopefully did for your emotional exchanges. So that's it, everybody. Thanks for coming, and I hope you enjoyed that. We will see you next time. Take care.